Hello guys, this is Raven from DJ Integrity. Welcome to Tech News episode 72. Apple has released a new Safari 14.1 update for macOS Catalina and macOS Mojave users after pulling it just a few days ago. Due to several reported issues, Apple first started rolling out Safari 14.1 on April 26 to fix browser fixes security vulnerabilities in WebKit. But this reportedly causes several browsing issues in both Safari and other browsers. As a result, Apple then pulled the update on May 1st, has now started to roll out again still under the version number 14.1. Microsoft is set to start the complete removal of the Adobe Flash from Windows 10 in the summer. The company will roll out a Windows 10 update for the removal of Adobe Flash Player, which would permanently remove Flash as a part of the operating system. It is no news that a more affordable pair of Google's own earbuds, the Pixel Buds, is coming. Today, a new pair of earbuds called the Pixel Buds A was accidentally announced by the official Android Twitter account. The now deleted tweet shows that earbuds in white along with a Pixel phone with a dialog box on its screen. The tweet confirms that Pixel Buds A has a fastest pair and a service that uses Bluetooth low energy and your device location feature a find a compatible Bluetooth device in range and allows you to connect to the Bluetooth device with just one tap. It's been a few years since Google started working on a new operating system named Fuchsia. It's an open source operating system that prioritizes security, updatability, and performance and that is aimed towards a range of devices. Now it seems that Google is finally ready to launch the operating system in the market with a version 1.0. A new product from the company named Google Nest Hub has appeared on Bluetooth SIG, which reveals that the device runs on Fuchsia 1.0. Google Chrome has enhanced user data security by handling hardware enforced stack protection technology that was first adopted on Windows 10 last year. The same enhanced security on the browser can help restrict attackers from exploiting security bugs on the system. The hardware enforced stack protection technology worked with computer based on Windows 20 H1 December update or later running on processor with Control 4 enforcement technology such as AMD Zen 3 Ryzen and 11th generation Intel CPUs. It is also a part of Chrome 90, the browser version that Google released last month. The US Department of Defense has said that it is tracking the Chinese Long March 5B rocket that is out of control and set to re-enter Earth's atmosphere this weekend. The Chinese rocket is expected to enter Earth's atmosphere around May 8th and the US Space Command is tracking the rocket's corners about where its debris may make an impact. Healthify Me launches real-time COVID-19 vaccination slot finder with WhatsApp notifications for when slots open up. The new VaccinateMe.in platform uses COVID APIs to help people find available vaccination slots nearby in real-time. Instagram is releasing a new feature for its story which is called Caption. The feature is currently available only for the stories functionalities while the company has confirmed that it will make its way to Reels as well as in the near future. Instagram took to Twitter to announce the Caption feature though which users will now be able to better understand what a person is saying in his or her story even when the sound is off. The feature already made it a way to IGTV videos last year while other functionalities inside the app are now getting access to it. Facebook's WhatsApp messaging service relaunched on Tuesday. It transfers money services between individuals in Brazil. After it was blocked by a central bank nearly 1 year ago, Chief Executive Officer Mark Zuckerberg said it on a Tuesday video. Brazil is the second country where the messaging service launched money transfers. In India, WhatsApp's biggest market with 400 million users, it got approval to start financial services in November. YouTube could soon make it easier for users to browse through videos by automatically translating video titles, description and captions in their native language according to a report. A new feature on the popular video sharing platform is powered by Google's own translator app. The few users have reportedly spotted the feature, which seems to have been enabled through a server-side change. It can be expected to be available for more users soon. However, translation to only Portuguese and Turkish has been spotted so far. Twitter said on Tuesday that it had bought news technology company Scroll, which it will use as a part of an upcoming subscription offering. Twitter has been working to offer new types of content on its social media sites, including audio and long-form content, after previously acquiring newsletter platform Review. Scroll allows users to subscribe and read news articles from publishers, including Insiders, BuzzFeed, and USA Today without ads. The company says that publishers who work with Scroll earn more money than they would be selling advertising. researchers have identified fossil bone fragments of sauropod dinosaurs dating back to about 100 million years from an area around West Kashi Hills district in Meghalaya. The GSI researchers noted that this is the first record of sauropods of probable dinosaurium origin discovered in the region. Sauropods have very long necks, long tails, small head relative to the rest of their body, and four thick and pillar-like legs. They are notable for the enormous sizes attained by some species, and the group includes the largest animals to ever lived on land. Smartphone battery is one of the top reasons why people keep charging their devices. Just like all batteries, smartphone batteries degrade over time, cutting short the smartphone life eventually. The things are beginning to change now, as researchers have found a way to boost a battery's lifetime by redesigning its structure and components. A team of researchers from the Japan Advanced Institute of Science and Technology have developed a new technology that could exponentially increase a battery life. The researchers discovered that the short life of batteries mainly because of the design of the lithium-ion batteries found on smartphones. A new report has suggested that MediaTek will lead the global smartphone processor market, while Qualcomm will lead the global 5G smartphone processor market. This marks a major shift in the industry. According to the report, the global smartphone application processor or system on chip market is expected to see a growth of 3% year on year in 2021. The modest growth arrives despite supply constraint, while the 5G smartphone market sees rapid growth. The Qualcomm and MediaTek are the both major processor makers, while the former expected to lead the 5G processor market with a 30% market share, while the latter will lead the global SoC market with a 37% share. A new report has revealed that Samsung is expected to retake the lead in the semiconductor supplier ranking in the second quarter of this year. The news arrives as the Intel is projected to see lackluster performance during the period. According to the reports, Intel's performance is set to lag in the second quarter, while the demand for DRAM market is expected to put the South Korean tech giant in the lead. As per the report, Intel had led the semiconductor manufacturing market all the way from 1993 to 2016, although it was deathstroke back in 2017 by Samsung due to the surge in the market demand. Samsung Galaxy A22 5G would come with a 15-watt charging support, and Algate certification on the TUV Rhineland website has suggested. It's speculated to have both 4G and 5G variants. The South Korean company is also tipped to launch Galaxy F52 based on the Galaxy A22 5G. Samsung Galaxy S21 Fan Edition is reported to be in works, and its production may start sometime in July. This is likely going to be an upgrade to a Samsung Galaxy S20 Fan Edition last year. The phone has to be made available in 4 color options like grey, light green, light violet and white. Apart from this, nothing has been leaked. The phone looks to be a stripped down version of Samsung Galaxy S21 series that is likely to be attached with more aggressive price point. SpaceX has received more than 500,000 pre-orders for its Starlink satellite internet service and anticipates no technical problems meeting the demand, founder Elon Musk said on Tuesday. Only limitation is high density of users in urban areas. A new patent from Hawaii has recently surfaced. This patent is for a game controller which is designed to work with a VR headset to allow users to control their action in virtual reality. The Chinese tech giant has awarded the patent earlier this week and carried the patent under CN30651365. In the patent application, a brief description can also be observed, which reads that the product in the patent is a gamepad, and also its purpose is to primarily be used for offering controller in a VR games or achieve other interactions in a virtual settings. The patent also arrives with certain sketches and 3D renders of this VR controller as well. Xiaomi is reportedly working on 3 high-end Android tablets to launch in the future. These tablets are codenamed as Nabu, Enuma and Elish, and they appeared in the code of MIUI 12.5 system application. The code suggested that Enuma will have a model number K81, Elish may carry a model number of K81A, and Nabu is likely to have the model number K82. These model numbers are associated with the rumored Mi Pad 5 range that the company is reported to be working on. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe, and follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.